talking about it, but we're going to make you talk about it. Yeah. In 1970, you were in goal for the St. Louis Blues for the probably one of the most famous goals in hockey history, Bobby Orr flying across the crease, probably one of the most famous pictures in all of sports. Can you relive that moment? You guys got swept in four by the Bruins, but that was an overtime game. That was a marathon.
We were an expansion team enforcing a top team out of the original six to play overtime. They must have been whining and crying in the dressing room. Playing overtime against an expansion team. They come out pretty quick and score. And Bobby floating, and I told him after, I said, Bobby, I showered before you landed.
Get out of here, I'm not waiting. So we'd hurry and go out.
tricks. We talk over a little bit. Maybe things I did something that I shouldn't have did, and say that you're cheating or things like that. And he'd ask me, and I'd just say, no, no. You did fine. I'd never tell him if he, you know, if he screwed up. He'd tell me. But we had a great time. We'd go out after and have fun. We never took the game with us. Never.
When you were young, did you used to say, hey, I'm going to the Hall of Fame before you are?
No, I never said that. I just used to say, I'll play longer than you are. You're playing. But he played just as long. He played till 39, I think.
That is amazing.
And he quit on his own terms. Me, I played till I couldn't skate anymore.
It's a great life. Why quit? Glenn, you know, I notice in baseball, a lot of catchers become managers. They see the whole field. You know, they're in a position to kind of get an overview and orchestrate what's going on, and that's how they learn the game and learn how to manage. And I notice that in, you know, juniors and college, a lot of goalies become head coaches. But I don't see a lot of goalies as head coaches in the NHL. Do you think a goaltender is predisposed to having the ability to coach more so than players in other positions?
I don't know why anybody would want to coach. I coach the kids at home, like in junior. But to stand behind the bench and see what's happening in a hockey game, I couldn't tell anything what was happening. You've got to be looking right down the field to see what's happening. And that's where it's enjoyable, when you can see everything, and what's going to happen and imagine. You talked about skating, and we were talking, and which I like that these guys that I played forward till I was 11 or 12, and so consequently becoming a good skater. And used to say that this was probably the most important ingredient in goalkeeping, was skating. But then start to figure out, and I've gone to the point that I think that the mind is the biggest thing that you have to have. If you don't know what's going to happen out there, you're in deep, deep trouble. But if you know where the danger area is and where how the play's going to develop, and when you're thinking of being properly, boy, oh boy, you're tough to beat. And when you're thinking of being properly, then it scores.
Man. Now, Tony, you fought with your right hand. I think you're only 8 dozen of trophy winners. You're left-handed, naturally. Is that an advantage for a goaltender? Does that throw a shooter off, or vice versa? Is it easier to score on a left-handed goaltender?
I don't think it's any advantage at all, because when a guy's coming in, he looks, and the scorers know what they're doing. They just look, the opening they go for, they don't. The good scorers I know never always shot at the same target. I mean, they shot for the opening. The guys that were the top scorers. Of course, the sluggers, I mean, you know, sluggers will hit you no matter what. They hit you right in the pass. But the good scorers, they just knew what they were doing. There's no advantage at all. It's just that, you know, you have to make sure, well, especially when you're young, you have to order all your equipment, because nobody carried the wrong hand goalie gloves and that kind of thing. It's inconvenient. But outside of that, no advantage whatsoever. But getting back to Glenn's thing here on the mind, very important. Goaltending, it's a lot to do with the mental part of the game, the preparation and the mental part in order to maintain that level of competition, to get yourself up every game so that you're ready and focused to play the game and maintain it year after year. To me, that was the toughest thing, because as you got older, tougher to do it. That's what I think is the toughest part of the game, not the physical part.
Corey, if you could elaborate on that. I know some of the Hawks said at the end of this season, it was just mentally debilitating. I mean, physically, you're playing hurt the last part of the season and into the playoffs. Most guys are nicked and dinged, but it is so draining mentally, isn't it?
Yeah, mentally and physically too. Especially in the playoffs, the amount of travel we did, going back and forth to Vancouver, and it's a lot of games, and it wears you down. And, you know, it's tough, and you know, I'm still pretty young, and I'm still learning the game, and learning a lot off the ice with all the travel and everything. And there's a lot that comes with it to prepare yourself, and stay ready, and like Tony.